industry is one of the most innovative and fastest growing industries in the world. The men and women of this industry work tirelessly to provide entertainment for the masses, and some of these provide the music. Music that we love. Music that we listen to when we're enjoying ourselves playing those video games. Music that we love. Music that we listen to when we're enjoying ourselves listening to video games. Do we even know who these people are? No. Would video games be the same without them? No. What you're about to hear are not.
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to an early edition of Average Giants. I'm your host, Average Gamer. This is my friend, Mighty Giant. We have a super amazo show today. What are we doing today?
Super amazeballs. That's what it is.
It is.
It's amazeballs.
It is. What are we doing today?
We are playing TerraTech, except this time with the multiplayer.
Yes, and they joined us back on the show. If you want to say hi again, Russ.
Hi, everybody.
Yes. Awesome. And the reason we have them back in the show is we actually had you guys on the show exactly like a month.
Yeah, pretty much a month ago.
When you kicked off your Kickstarter. And how did that go for you?
Well, it went amazingly well in the first week. And then it kind of slowed down. And then it kind of stayed slow, and it got a bit scary. And then in the last 6 days, it just went mental and carried us over the line. So it was an exhausting and incredible experience.
I'm glad to hear it. And once again, the important thing there is that it carried you over the line, so you guys are completely funded now for making the game, which is so amazing. As well, about halfway through the month, I remember I was just checking Steam out, and you guys got onto the Steam store as well, right?
Yeah, that was kind of lucky, actually, because we've been thinking about, you know, getting our Steam page up, and we thought, you know, we probably want to put a demo up there, and I'll have to check out the Steamworks SDK, and not really sure what will be involved in integrating that, and we just managed to sort of get it together in time to get our Steam demo up just at the start of our last week, and that was made such a difference, honestly. We were all shocked. That was basically the thing that kicked it all off, I think, that last rush.
I'm glad to hear it. That's cool.
Sorry, I'm missing.
Yeah, no, it's all good. So, one of the biggest things that we wanted to show off is this Sumo Showdown, which is really neat. So, I'll just explain. We have this little cockpit here, and what we're going to do is I'm going to take 20 minutes to design my Sumo. And then Mighty Giant is going to design his own Sumo. And then for the end of the show, we're going to see which Sumo stacks up.
Excellent. I can't wait to see, guys.
So, what was it? What was the other thing you guys did with Steam? What was that other thing?
The other thing we did with Steam?
What was the other thing you did with Steam?
I'm not sure. I mean, we've had the page up for I guess a bit over a month now, but hasn't been a demo until now. We didn't do green light. I guess that's an unusual thing. We managed to get approved just pretty much straight away by speaking to Valve. Yeah, we never really took advantage of that very much, you know. We were approved to put a page up,
so you guys passed green light.
Yeah, they
well,
you guys.
Yeah, we can look at it that way.
You guys skipped it. You guys got the golden ticket.
That's what it feels like, man. Yeah, absolutely.
Because yeah, we, you know, you hear all those nightmare stories about green light, and then you hear like the magical fantasy story of Steam just going, we like you.
Yeah.
You can pass. Yeah. Opens the giant golden gates of
that's
gaming.
What just did that? Aperture Tag. Have you heard of that one?
It's
a mod for Portal 2. Yeah, but you don't use portals, you use the liquids.
Oh,
yeah. And Valve liked it so much, they were like, you know what? Slap cost on this, we're going to put it on our...
Oh, the paint gun.
Yeah.
It is, yeah.
But anyway, So what have you guys learned from your successful Kickstarter that you want to bring in the future?
Well, we've certainly learned that we don't want to do another Kickstarter anytime soon. it's gonna take a year or so to recover from that experience, I think.
Yeah.
No, it's an amazing learning experience. You know, it's one of those things. You can get a lot of advice about it before you do it because everyone's an expert, and you know, there's loads of people out there who've been through it who are very free with, you know, sharing what they've learned. But a lot of the stuff you don't really, you can't understand it until you've actually gone through it. You know what I mean?
Totally.
So there are some things that, you know, people told us this would happen, and it's not that we didn't believe them, but I don't think we really understood until it actually did happen.
Mm-hmm.
Like for example, the way it just all kind of comes together at the end. You know, everyone was saying that. You get a big spike at the end, don't worry, you're looking good. And we were like, yeah, but we're less than 50% funded. You know, we've got just more than a week to go. Where are all those people going to come from? I don't understand. Who are they? Where have they been? but it's right, you know, there's just this sort of magical thing that happens at the end that people seem to get behind it. And it can all turn around incredibly fast.
It is very. I guess one of the things that we did here is the fact that a lot of the time, or this is sort of like a common occurrence where most people, if they're not, what's the percentage of funding by a certain date? What is?
So 70% of Kickstarters that get over 50% funded make it. Is what it's currently sitting at, around.
And that's not within a certain time frame, or is it?
No, just 50% of, or 70% of Kickstarters that make half of their funding actually make it.
Yeah, we heard some similar sort of factoids ourselves, mm-hmm. And that's great. You know, it's good to know, but nothing can really comfort you when you're in that sort of yawning. of despair in the middle of your Kickstarter when, you know, the backers have just kind of, the new backers have really slackened off and you're trying to imagine where you're suddenly going to get 600 backers from in the space of a few days.
That is very true.
But there's lots of, you know, there's lots of great techniques you can use that work. One of the great ones is the concept of, I think they usually call it critical mass, where, well, that's probably one of the phrases for it, where if you're able to combine together like multiple different efforts to get the word out at the same time, then because they're all happening at once, it's much more effective than each of them individually.
Mm-hmm.
And we saw several times occasions where we managed to actually line a few things up so they all happened at once. We would get this huge swing. I mean, noticeably, again, at the start of our last week, when we had our Steam demo came out on Steam, and we did a little bit of advertising, we put nice one. We put a banner on, you know, RPS and a couple of other places. And at roughly the same time, I had a Gamma Sutra article come out, or I had it featured that I'd written the previous week about one of the sharing features that we have in the game, the snapshot thing.
Yeah.
And those things all just came together, and the whole is more than the sum of the parts, you know. And actually, a similar thing happened again on the Saturday, our penultimate day. Chris, the designer, and me were in the office, and you know, we normally do our a development live stream at 5 p.m. on the weekdays. That's been our routine. And we thought, well, look, we'll come in at the weekend, and we'll just do a random live stream as well on Saturday and Sunday. Just, you know, we don't know who's out there, we don't know who's going to watch, but it's exciting, so we'll just put one up, and maybe we'll do an AMA at the same time. Why not? You know, AMAs are supposed to be good, so we don't spend a lot of time on Reddit, but we'll put one up there and see if anyone joins in. So we just kind of did this almost on the spur of the moment, and you know, after about an hour, there was only about two questions on the AMA, and we were thinking, well, you know, we weren't expecting too much. And then around the time the live stream started, things started picking up, and every time we checked the AMA, the number of likes and questions had gone up by a bit more than last time we checked.
And
at the same time, we were getting more people in the Twitch chat, and suddenly, you know, it was just going faster and faster, and we were the number one thread on the IAMA subreddit. And we had like 70 viewers or something on Twitch, which is about four times more than we normally get. I don't know where they all came from, but it was brilliant. So we ended up streaming for, I think, 6 hours straight on Saturday after thinking, you know, we just go on half an hour and say hello.
Well, that's good. That's
always a blessing. Yeah.
That actually carried us over the line. You know, we didn't expect that at all, but that took us, we got about £6,000 in.
Huh.
Over the course of that. It was amazing.
Yeah, I know that if I ever did a Kickstarter for anything, I couldn't, because I'd just be like staring at it in a rain cloud above my head.
It's very stressful.
I would get insanely depressed.
Pound cannon.
I don't know why. It's just probably, well, I guess I'd have to have something to actually kickstart, unless you're like some of them freeloaders out there. God.
What?
Yeah, there's been some interesting stories recently. It was kind of getting us down a bit that a lot of those things have to blow up, you know,
like
the last
the
2 weeks
salad.
Of our Kickstarter.
Yeah.
The potato salad, you know, the York Ventures one, and there was another one, that Ariel one with the letter from Vladimir Putin, or I don't know what was going on there. But
yeah.
Wasn't great timing for that kind of publicity, to be honest.
No, certainly was not. There are people at the magazine where I worked that are not very happy with Yogg's cast right now. Though, admittedly, they didn't know who they were before, but still. Oh, there we go.
So I'm watching your creative efforts with interest here, guys. How are you finding the sumo mode?
Well, so it was funny because we just made two little tiny things with wheels just to give it a try before we started it. The Shazbotter. And
that worked pretty well.
Yeah, considering that we were both the same item and we both had same strengths and weaknesses, I ended up losing, but that's because I completely forgot what direction I was going in. There was no front. It was just two wheels.
It did its job. Oh, I know what I mean.
What are you going to do? What are you going to put on there? So with the update for multiplayer, what else was implemented?
Well, the main thing is this mode, the sumo mode. You know, we've been thinking about this for a little while, and you know, it was quite frustrating that everyone was excited about multiplayer, and we weren't in a position to do multiplayer.
Mm-hmm.
But we thought, we suddenly realised we could dust off this idea that we'd had a little while before, and because of the way it works with this kind of narrow, limited space. Although, you know, one way to play it would be kind of taking turns to build and then running them automated, you could also turn it into local multiplayer and just have, you know, a few controllers plugged in.
Mm-hmm.
And that was another kind of thing that we didn't really think through too much. We just sort of thought, well, that might work, and then it did work.
And besides
and it
tends
to be quite good.
Oh, sorry. Besides the sumo, is there any other games for multiplayer, like racing or?
Well, not yet. There can be. You know, that's the
I guess
the
would have been more
mode.
The question of is there going to be?
Oh, yeah, loads. I mean, you know, the full design of the game will have a synchronous multiplayer mode. Again, we'll have to see how we go about introducing it. Maybe we start off with just a server-based thing, and then eventually we go larger scale. But the idea was always that the full sort of story game mode would allow you to play with other people or against other people, and then all these extra challenge modes that we're building around, all the ones that are appropriate for it, we can add multiplayer to as well. There's loads of scope for it. And some of these game modes, you know, we didn't necessarily know at the outset that we were going to do them. They're just evolutions of things that we've experimented with that have turned out to work. So there's probably going to be a lot more kind of multiplayer game modes that we haven't even conceived of yet that are just going to happen as we mess around with stuff. That seems to be the way it's going.
Your creation is starting to look like a lobster or a crab.
That's okay.
You're going crab core, man.
I am going crab core. I'm
crab core.
You aren't even ready for this crab core.
You are going to be called the dirty crab.
Oh, okay. I'm okay with this.
But you're giving me ideas, so that's good.
It's really amazing watching people play this mode. The story of this is quite funny. My producer, Saywon, and I were working together at IdeaWorks years ago. We used to play at lunchtimes this game called Fantastic Contraption, which I'm sure you know.
Oh, yes. Yep. Oh, I can't. Yeah. I saw
the Amazing Contraption.
Yeah, they have a new one on Steam as well.
Well, it's gone from strength to strength. I mean, it brought it out on iOS a few years ago. But back then, I mean, this was in like, 2008 or something. It was a flash game. Mm-hmm. And it was kind of a puzzle game, you know, with the levels. You had to complete the levels, and there were some other kinds of competition. And we used to play this in the office, but we just ended up playing this sort of game with it that we'd invented ourselves, where we take the level designer, where you make your own thing, and pick a level that just had a sort of a podium. And then we would take turns to make a machine, and we'd each have to build in one half of the field, not the other half, and we'd take turns, and your machine had to push the other machine off. And then you'd send it to the other person, and they would fix their machine so it pushed your machine off and send it back, and then you would pass it back, you know. And it was just a hilarious amount of fun. And ever since we started getting to this point with TerraTech, we've been really wanting to do something like that for this, because just remembering how much fun that was. And that's part of the inspiration for Sumo Mode, you know. We just kind of knew it would be fun because of what we'd done before. And it turned out to be better than we expected.
So we're just switching around right now, so that, because his 20 minutes is up.
Oh.
So yep. We are just
right.
Swap yep. spots.
Oh god, I need more water.
Gotta build stuff. Don't put your drink on that table. I have spilt it because that table is quality.
Alrighty.
This is what we call professionalism. We're professionals. It's
inspiration.
Professional.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah, you can see. Okay, so yes, I am also very much excited for Sumo. I saw some of the Kickstarter levels that you guys got. You got some of the big ones. Like, you have the one person who's going to be playing the CEO of one of your corporations, I saw. And then you had four people that are going to help design the blocks. Oh, what are you guys kind of expecting for how you're going to interact with them?
For how are we expecting it to go?
Yeah, exactly. Like, what kind of blocks are you going to be making with the players and that kind of thing?
Well, it's up to them, really. We've got, you know, loads of ideas for blocks already, and we have this sort of general concept of the themes of the different corporations. You need to stick the big block onto the cab there.
Back
you can't do it the other way around.
Oh, I can't do this. My controls are all weird.
I was gonna say something, but then I was like, wait a minute, I have to fight him.
Well, give me a chance, man. Remember, you played it all last time, so I'm just trying to figure this out. You have a distinct advantage over me right now.
But you seemed to know so much about the game last time when you were helping me build.
Yeah, exactly. I knew so much about it. What? I don't even know what wheels I want to use. This is going to be hard.
So, now that you guys, you're coming onto the Steam store, you have the Kickstarter done, there's my wife running by because she doesn't want to be in the show.
Oh, hello!
What kind of, do you have an ETA of, like, when is development going to be starting? I guess the question I want to ask that I know that there's no real answer to is, when can I play the full game?
Yeah, well, I mean, you're right, that's not very, very clear at the moment, but development will be continuing, you know, pretty much immediately. This week we are kind of taking stock of things and, you know, going back to our planning and working out what everything's going to cost, and just kind of settle down a bit after the Kickstarter. So we might not make much development progress this week, but we'll be cracking on with it again next week. At that point we'll be starting to enter the beta program, which means that Yeah, you need to grab the big block and stick it onto the cap.
There we go.
The other way around.
Sorry,
there you go.
Sorry.
Now you've done that, you can move the cap if you want. So from now on, like, most of our focus is going to be on the beta builds. So we'll be testing out all of our new content and features that we're putting in. We'll go to the beta backers first. And then fairly regularly after that, we'll bring some of those changes back into the free demo just so that other people can see what's going on. But we'll be prioritizing the beta guys now.
Yeah, of course.
And that will go through until our early access launch, which is supposed to be in October.
Perfect.
So that's when, that's a major release point. That's a good point to get hold of the game if you're not involved in the beta. And then in terms of the actual final launch, we're thinking around the end of first quarter next year then maybe, but there's lots of other things to see about.
That's concrete. No, I'm just kidding. Can you pass me my laptop?
Yes.
I need to make a new mod.
Oh, yes. Do you want me to unplug it? How do you unplug apples?
It's magnet.
How do you unplug apples?
It's magnet.
There's magnets and apples? Why is there magnets and apples? It doesn't make any sense.
There we go. Okay, perfect.
Okay, so I apparently have this backwards.
Oh, I'm so excited. What was it? We have another group of friends that I play some games with, and we were playing, what is it called? Robocraft? Which is not similar to this. It's you make a robot out of blocks, and it's a vehicle-type game, and then you go into death matches to play against them. And so we were checking it out, and I kind of wanted to see how close that game kind of was to this game, but not at all. I didn't actually have that much fun with that game. This one I have way more fun with, so it's nice to see, because they felt like they were much more gimmicky, and your game, you guys have so much that you want to add to it that I'm really excited to play. So, it's good.
Cool, eh? Glad you're liking it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there's a few other games out there that are in the kind of, modular vehicle building space. And it's been really good for us to see that, first of all, that there's some other people doing that, because that's a pretty good indication you're doing something right if you're not the only person doing it. Secondly, it's been good to see that all the other players in this space have kind of got their own angle, and that we're not like tripping right over anyone's toes, making something that feels uncomfortably close. Robocraft, they've got a cool game, and it's very much got its own feel. It doesn't feel like TerraTech. There isn't a huge overlap in terms of the kind of people that like them, I think. And then you could say the same about, slightly more distant relation, but Kerbal gets mentioned a lot in the context of TerraTech. And again, it's a different feel of game, it's a different kind of pace of play, and it leaves plenty of room for us to work, if you see what I mean.
Yeah, completely. That's funny, I would never have thought of Kerbal and TerraTech in the same place either. I'm much more of a fan of TerraTech. I find there's so much more to do, and it's a lot more strategy and a lot more fun with how you can build things, so. But that's just me.
Well, I can't wait for you to get your hands on the actual strategy, mechanics to the game when they come out. That's one of the things that we're starting to put more focus onto now. But all the stuff around, how you build out your base and set up automation so that you can harvest a load of stuff and then start using that to make multiple vehicles and control them all at once. That's going to get quite interesting.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I
focus.
See.
I'm focusing.
You're just
going right
to be
now.
Driving backwards at me so you can protect your cockpit, huh?
What are you talking about?
Huh?
that spinny thing is not going to work there. There, I'll just.
Oh, perfect. Right on top.
Yeah, exactly. We're throwing you away. Let's see. Oh, it moves a lot better now. That's good. It's kind of hard to turn this thing.
I tried to put rockets on it, but it didn't give me the effect that I was thinking it would. Obviously, because rockets don't have traction.
There.
Have you guys watched any of the Sumo stuff that we've shown on our channel? Have you seen any of that?
I saw a little bit of it. I'm not sure if Mighty Giant has.
No, I haven't had a chance.
Yeah, some of the guys, some of our regulars, are getting pretty hardcore at this moment, and the things they've been building, honestly, are just fearful. You would cry, I think, if you saw some of the stuff these guys have been doing.
I'm sure they could work this over in a matter of minutes. I was thinking at the beginning, I was like, you know what? Hovercraft. I'm going to do a hovercraft. That way he can't even touch me. But then logistically, I was like, I don't even want to think about this with physics right now for 20 minutes.
Yeah, the hovercraft is probably the worst possible design, I'd say.
Yeah.
Zero traction. But it's fun to see some of the different strategies that people have come up with. You know, some people go out all out for just weight and power and try and steamroller, but then other people will go for all the guns and try and just kind of like lock horns and then shell them from above. That's pretty effective. And there's some pretty cool designs that are kind of designed to try and flip over and then work when they're upside down, that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
I'm just seeing what there is.
That's what I thought originally with that thing, but I couldn't get the wheels to work how I wanted them to.
This could potentially work. I'm not going for size, I'm going for...
You have 11 minutes left. 11 minutos.
Shh, don't say anything.
Should we start a timer?
Stop talking. I'm thinking about this. I'm trying to see what there is.
Yeah, it's pretty good for comedy, this mode. One of the things that was a bit unexpected was that because those digger scoops, the way that I've implemented the physics on the animations is not, shall we say, accurate. It's a bit of a hack, and that means that when you get two of them touching each other on enemy vehicles, their results are a bit unpredictable. It's just a bug, it's a total physics bug. But the effect of it when it happens is it literally looks like the tanks are picking each other up and like doing a jiu-jitsu throw and throwing them out of the ring. It's amazing.
Okay, yeah, I'm gonna have to check out more of those videos.
We might have to leave that one in and call it a feature.
Yeah, totally.
So you only get so many of everything.
Yes.
Finite thingies.
Yeah, otherwise I would have had much more for big wheels.
We're okay, though. Wait, maybe that'll shoot my stuff up. This is totally going to work, I tell you.
Oh, no!
That didn't work at all. We're okay. This will be a fast reassembly. What the hell? I pressed the wrong thing, didn't I?
Yeah, I'll take responsibility for that. It's a common bug, that one. If you accidentally pull away the wrong piece, the whole thing goes.
Okay. Do I have enough time to do this now?
You can.
You can do it.
Try hitting. If you hit B to float your cab up.
Sorry, which?
Then it,
B.
If you hit the B key to float the cab, then it's a bit easier to attach things onto it.
Okay.
And just try and drag it really in close until it attaches. Yeah.
There we go.
Put your mouse over the top of the cab. There you go.
Come on. Oh, it's right there. It's okay. I know what I did. I know what I have to make, and it's just a matter of putting it all back together. That's not how you do it. So we're still in the game. It's okay.
What? So can you, since I've already made mine, can you give us some of the thought process of what you're doing to destroy the dirty crab?
I don't know yet. lots of explosives.
Okay.
That's pretty much it. Lots of explosives. Wait, I wanted to go on.
Oh, you're switching it. So your cockpit's in the front there.
I didn't mean to do that, but it's just the way it is. Oh, wait, no, I want to take my thing off, but I'm worried that I might blow it up if I take my cockpit off. Is that what's going to happen if I take my cockpit
no,
off?
No, you can move the cockpit, that's fine, you can put it somewhere else.
Okay, good.
You only get a bug if you take off the bit that the cockpit is attached to.
Mm.
Okay, so that's okay. We're all right. How much time do I have left now that I just blew up my
Do you want me to tell you? 8 minutes.
Oh, that's fine. I was pretty much done.
No, you're good. You're good. You did that in like 8 minutes, so.
So.
You just don't have any rockets, like I do.
Don't need rockets. I have turning things. See the turning things?
But the rockets are the key to the dirty crab.
You think so, wouldn't you? And you just gotta put everything back together, everything back in the right place. My 3 pounds goes at the.
So, how long until you guys bring this off the computer and start competing against Lego?
Yeah, don't say that name too loud, but we're trying to stay under the radar.
Yeah, no worries.
You know, we're actually quite keen to take this to the level of doing physical toys. It's something that people ask about quite a lot, and we'll probably start with some kind of ability to just do effectively a 3D print so that you can get a physical version of the thing you've built. But eventually, you know, we'd love to make it if you could actually have separate pieces and snap them together. Because that'd be pretty fun.
Yeah, totally. That'd be really cool.
Yes, I can't do that. Whatever, it's the off-center smashy thing. Oh, it's... All right.
You'll never take me alive, Giant.
Oh, you're going to love this. This is going to be great.
You've got 6 minutes left.
I have 6 minutes to add more explosives.
Yeah.
What's Rockets. This?
Put hover jets underneath it.
Proper fuel tank? I don't need a fuel tank. What else do I got? Hover jets.
Yeah, all the hover jets.
Oh, I forgot to put a coil laser on. Oh, I got some more coil lasers I can put on. There.
Oh, I'm so looking forward to this.
Maybe I need something like a cool racing strike.
I can see how an undo button would be difficult.
Yeah, it's tricky because, you know, sometimes you do want to pull out that piece and,
Oh, what's this?
You know, it's a bit weird if you can just kind of rebuild them automatically.
Mm-hmm.
But we might have a sort of fail-safe that, that stops you from doing a really destructive thing or does it like an are you sure or something.
What else do I got? What else? I'll just take one of these because it looks good.
Fair enough.
Look at this. Come and get me, man.
Woo! That's a lot of... I don't know. These are going to be some close matches.
Look at this. Look at me go.
It's a lot of firepower.
Even yeah. I'm afraid of it. And I got a nice turning... a nice decent quick turn.
Yep.
So I can keep my ass away from you. So I got that.
That's going to be very important.
Although I think I just saw damage to my wheel from running over a bullet. A shell.
Don't worry about it.
Yeah, I'm actually getting damage from running over the bullets. That's not good.
Don't worry about it, Ty.
Don't worry. Don't worry about it, Brett. Hey, Brett. Don't worry about it, Brett.
Oh, man.
Brett? Hey, Brett. I don't know if I put one of these on. Right there. So then I can go... But although I need a fuel tank, wouldn't I?
Mm-hmm. So, oh, you did put rockets.
What are you talking about? What are you talking about?
You have to put rockets. That's the rule of TerraTech. Everything requires rockets.
Oh.
You know, if you're going to use rockets, you need fuel tanks as well.
Yeah, I'm finding a fuel tank.
There's a big one there.
I'm not using a big fuel tank. I don't need a big fuel tank. I need a small fuel tank that won't blow me. Oh, God. What's this?
You may want to save to...
Where is it?
Before you drive off the edge. Oh, right over there.
There it is. I need two of those, don't I?
You don't need to.
Donk. Although this can make me a lot more explosive, which could be an issue. What's thruster? Oh, there it is.
Got it?
Yep.
Okay.
Wait for it.
So what are you going to call this?
The Bulldozer? I don't know.
The Bulldozer? The Bulldozer versus the Dirty Crab?
So I'm curious, guys. Are you going to do the auto fight, or have you, or you got your controllers? You're going to do it mano a mano.
Oh, how do you save now? How did you save?
Oh, hit escape, and, or just that little square? Oh. Yeah.
Take a picture.
There is no way that we would leave the computer to do our fighting for us.
Wait. We might have to do that at least once, though.
We will do it at least once. Yeah. There, but I think everybody has learned that Nick and I love to be competitive with things, like
yes.
when we did Clusterpuck.
All right, Lord. We'll switch spots again.
Yeah, okay.
I had 2 minutes left, so I'll just admire it. Oh, that's nice.
Oh, it sounds beautiful.
It's so nice. It's so aesthetically pleasing.
You know what? Actually, get used to that view, because you're never going to see it all in one piece again.
You'd like to think that. You would like to think that. I will say, good luck, sir.
Good luck.
So I'm just going to warn you guys before you jump in. Sometimes the detection of the joypads is a little bit tricky. So if you have any trouble, just restart the game with when your joypads are definitely connected, and reload it. That should work.
So I'm playing.
Okay.
I'm
Nothing
playing
happened.
Controller.
It's cool.
I'm playing controller, and he's going to be playing
keyboard.
The keyboard.
Okay.
I think he has a lot more control though.
I have another controller, but it's... I have two.
Yeah, I
should have
brought both of my controllers, and I didn't think about it.
Okay, so, load vehicle. The Dirty Crab. Oh, we still have the Shazbot.
We still got the Shazbot.
Which,
go
it's
Shazbot
the mystery.
Versus the Dirty
It's the mystery vehicle, because it's hiding behind.
The Shazbot versus the Dirty Crab.
We should
crab.
Do the autos with the Shazbot.
Turn in the bulldozer.
Okay. The Dirty Crab versus the Bulldozer. Fight one.
Oh,
begin.
God, let me get ready for this. Move your drink to my way. Pick up. What? I'm going to get you now.
No!
We're going to do...
What happened to the Dirty Crab?
Oh, yeah.
No!
Go...
I can't even turn. Oh. No!
What?
Let's see, try this again, shall we? Okay,
awesome.
Dirty Crab.
Okay.
Right?
Yep.
Bulldozer.
Okay, there you go.
Local
fight. No!
No!
What's going on?
Are you just getting a cab on
yes.
its own?
Yeah, just getting a cab on its own.
Can you try, if you just select one, if you just select the Dirty Crab.
Okay.
And then there's a modify design button. If you only select the one.
It's gone? Why is there a picture of it with nothing else? That's not good.
I have never seen that before.
And yet...
You found a new bug.
Yep, that's what we do here on Average Giants.
Okay, so if you can, try to remake... look at your picture and try to remake it as quick as you can.
Okay.
I'll give you 5 minutes.
Oh, man.
That's huge!
5 minutes.
Do you think you can do it in 5 minutes? I win by default! Woo! Two greatest words in the English language. Default! Default! Default!
Neither of those statements are correct.
The masked streamer. Oh, hi, masked streamer.
Hey, Bill. That's Bill.
That's Bill?
Yeah.
Oh, crap, I named it after him. You get to see the bulldozer.
I have to remake.
This maybe
is
it,
be
maybe
more
it'll
glorious
have to
than
be,
ever before.
Okay, maybe I'll have to give you 10 minutes then if you're going to completely remake. Oh, you're trying to encapsulate your...
Right?
Oh.
Right? Yeah, you jelly this.
See, yeah, the masked streamer loves the name Bulldozer.
Okay.
So yeah, this will be fun if he can make something extra special in the next 9 minutes. But I think you have a good advantage because you know what I'm up against or what you're up against now.
Yeah.
And you're going to modify accordingly.
My poor Dirty Crab. I already miss it.
You can still make the Dirty Crab. It just
no,
has to be more dirty.
Now I'm making the tractor.
It has
of
to be
doom!
It has to be at least 3 times more dirty.
Actually, if you could email me the picture for the Dirty Crab, I'd quite like to debug that.
Definitely. Should be able to. Oh, I think. Wait, we need these. Okay, you know what? You need to go.
You need to go backward. Yeah, go back one. Throw your crab claws on it.
Crab claw.
Crab claw. Going crab core. Oh, it's so hot in here.
I know.
It's because it's so intense. This is going to be so intense. I like that you made it so that you only can use so many of one item before
it stops.
Because then you just see you'd have your a capsule, and then you'd have like 400 of those. And you just see... blah, 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 blah. Put them under the vehicle, and then you'll launch yourself into the air. Would that work? Would that work if you launched yourself?
I don't think so.
Oh. I was hoping that would work.
Okay. More machine gun.
Oh boy, I'm concerned.
I get to refine my design.
Sort of concerned, not really.
No, I don't think it should be. Nothing will ever be as good as the dirty crab.
The dirty crab. This will be Crab 2.0. This will be Crab Core. This is the name of it, Crab Core.
It's totally Crab Core. It's my new type of music, too.
Your type of music?
Yeah.
You can get...
No!
I think this is a... So, now that I have my design, can I take that anywhere else in the game?
Oh, good question.
Absolutely, yes. You can load that into the main mode. You can load it into any of the other modes. the only mode which limits what you can load in is Sumo mode, so that you can't cheat by making like a crazy thing in a different mode and load it in.
Okay.
There.
Is that what you're doing? That it?
It looks like the Jurassic Park Jeep.
It's simple yet elegant. Actually, yep. It's just a hulking mass of yellow things. Don't worry, you got 5 minutes.
Do I?
6 minutes.
I'm gonna have to use those.
You're gonna have
Sorry,
to use,
guys.
Use many more later. You better check and see how you can turn.
I know.
You better check that out before it's too late.
Check it out.
Yep. To see what's it all about. I'm sorry I have a stutter today.
Oh, I can totally not turn.
That's okay, you only really need to go forwards.
Technically. Unless you want to deke.
Okay. I had a plan.
You're still gonna use your thrusters?
Why would I not use my thrusters? If I can have rockets.
You're gonna use your bone thrusters?
There is no reason not to have rockets.
This will be Crab Core 2.0 Turbo Alpha edition.
Oh, you can connect.
I'm getting
well, that saves
space.
That's
an interesting concept.
Space.
Look at all that space you have now for all that rocket. That's how they did it in the distance showdown. They just added things to things.
That would make sense.
Nice.
This is like ground Kerbal.
Yeah.
And that's a compliment. There's not enough lasers. I think you need more lasers.
Pretty much, I'm going to call it the Laser Floyd.
Laser Crab Floyd?
Yeah, Laser Crab Floyd.
Because it's still crab. It'll always be a crab in our hearts. You got crabs, assface!
Wow, I don't think anybody's going to get that one.
Yes, that is a wonderful reference from the almighty Clone High. If you've never seen it, do so.
Time?
You have 4 minutes. This is it. You think you're ready? Oh my god, you do not turn. Turning is not an option. Let me see your weapon.
That's really the danger zone right there.
Oh boy.
That's the danger zone.
You don't like.
And then this.
Oh, now stop. You can stop better than I can. That's for sure. Is there brakes?
please let this work.
Oh. I got my fingers crossed for you.
Okay. Right. Sumo challenge. All right. Okay, so we have the please let this work.
And the bulldozer.
Versus the bulldozer.
Please work.
Fight in local.
Yeah!
Yeah! Oh my god, these things are huge.
I'm ready. I'm ready.
Okay, we're ready.
Here we go.
Oh man. Oh man. Go! I can't even go for you. Yeah. Oh no, no, no.
No, no. Oh man, you just knocked off like most of my stuff. No, you're not. No.
Jets are powerful.
Oh no, you've just mounted me. We can't do anything.
No. Wait, get out of there. Get out. Oh, my drill! Both drills!
Oh no!
You took out my drills!
Good! Oh, I can grab stuff too, can I? Oh, sit
in the danger zone!
Oh, yeah! No.
And now for the coup de grace!
Oh, dang it! Okay.
Okay, rematch?
Yes, rematch.
That was best of three?
Okay.
And then we'll do the auto.
Whew.
Nice work, guys.
Oh, no.
Thank you.
All right, here we
Thanks
go.
For joining us. This is Sumo Woo. Mode is amazing. If anybody wants to try this out, go on Steam. They have the demo available with Sumo Mode right now. You can play this right now. You just need to get a friend.
Okay.
Yeah. No. Yes.
Right.
So much destruction.
Oh, jeez. Oh yeah, you totally had this one just from sheer size.
I think I went into the Jaws theme song at the end there. I don't know what that was about.
I thought it was Jurassic Park.
Okay, first let's do the Shazbotter.
Versus the Shazbotter?
Versus the Shazbotter. In auto.
Auto. Okay, this will be fantastic. Go, other Shazbot!
Go, left Shazbot!
Go, Shazbot!
Go, Shazbotter! They don't know what they're doing! What are they doing?
They're dancing! Why are they dancing? You made a robot dance simulator!
Oh my god!
Look at him
this
shooting!
This is amazing!
Oh, I'm getting a bit of a lead on you! Oh, we can just... God. What is this happening?
Oh man!
Oh, this is
beautiful.
He's like, I'm gonna get. I don't know
why they're writing themselves. It doesn't do anything.
They're flipped upside down.
Okay, that one's not gonna go anywhere.
I'm sorry, but that's amazing.
Okay, please let this work versus the bulldozer. I bet when we do auto, I bet it'll be a complete upset and the bulldozer will just wreck.
No,
please let this work.
You have so much potential going forward. So.
You think so? Let's see. Let's see what happens.
Hilarious.
It looks a lot bigger.
Oh, what?
See?
What?
See? I told you!
I did it wrong, but he
got out of it! He got out of it!
Oh
man!
Oh,
what
no.
are his rockets?
Oh no!
Oh, but he knocked off your mouth
thing! Oh, he's getting wheels off!
Oh my god!
Oh, he's knocking things off slowly but surely!
Oh no!
Oh, here goes another wheel!
Please let this work! It's
oh,
not working!
Everything is falling off.
He is not working!
The bulldozer...
Oh, hang on!
What's going on?
I think
now?
He's shooting some stuff! He's shooting stuff!
It's not doing anything!
Neither of them are going to get to the cockpits. He's trying to use his rockets.
I used too much side rockets. I should have gone forward rockets. Oh, I think you better restart.
Yeah, okay. That one's a draw.
Oh, wait. Oh. Okay,
or is it a draw?
Wait a minute. Oh, no. Almost every... Oh, no.
Yeah!
Oh,
yeah, he's still alive.
He doesn't have any
Look
control.
At him. He's like, yeah, I did it. Yeah! Dang it! Okay, I'm gonna call that one.
My cube is still
I'm gonna call that one for the please let this work. We'll switch where they start.
That was hilarious.
And we'll throw in...
I'm sorry, but the automatic stuff is amazingly...
We're going to throw in a Shazbotter as well.
Ooh, he's going to upset everyone.
He's
just going to be like, hey guys, now, hey guys.
Would we be able to do a YouTube series with this? Because this has a lot of potential.
Oh god, this is so funny. Oh man, this is different.
Please do.
Alright, perfect.
They're attacking from the front.
Oh! Oh! The Shazbotter wins!
Really?
The Shazbotter wins.
How's that even possible?
Oh,
I see.
He just stood there and shimmied. He just is like, hey guys. Hey guys, go fight.
Nobody can beat the shimmy.
Oh my god.
Should we have two Shazbotters to duke out?
Two Shazbotters.
Or a Dirty Crab. Let's have a Dirty Crab in there.
Just, you're just going to have a little box?
Yeah. Go Dirty Crab!
Go little box! Ultimate fight. He's still
going. Oh god!
They're gonna take each other out again. Oh, the dummies! And then there he is, just going. Doo, 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 doo. Is he gonna throw himself off? I bet you he is.
No. Oh, the Shazbotter gets a good hit there.
Shazbotter's starting to really move. He's still shimmying and dancing.
He has a reason to move now.
Oh god, this is.
Oh,
hilarious.
Oh, oh! This is brutal.
Oh,
this is brutal.
He's going up on top of him. And what? There's so many items over there. Go get
them.
Yeah,
look at that.
No, it's not going anywhere.
Is sumo mode much like other modes where you can pick parts and put them on in the middle of a fight at all? If they
Only if I've left some more bugs in there.
Oh, okay.
You're not supposed to be able to do that now.
Oh. Okay,
oh.
Now what you need to do?
Yep.
Put two of each of the same vehicle. Or like, so that's just Bulldozer versus Bulldozer.
Oh, I see.
Dirty
I
Crab
see.
Versus Dirty Crab.
Okay.
We'll see.
Go lefty.
Go righty.
All right, lefty, don't let me down. Oh my god, the destructive power. Ooh, that's a good
how
hit.
How did that happen?
Oh, lefty, no.
Oh, man,
lefty, no.
He might just drive himself off, though.
Oh, lefty,
oh.
No.
Oh, boy. Use... Oh.
Oh.
Oh no, you just lost one of your crab claws. Dude!
Lefty,
dude.
No!
Yeah.
Nice.
And then he falls off too.
Alright, now Bulldozers. Oh my god, this is so much fun.
This is amazing.
And this took us an hour to have this much fun. Like, this is crazy. But,
well, I love the design part of it, because that really gets your brain juices flowing, and then the mindless hilarity that is... Whoa!
Oh.
Whoa!
Oh no, lefty again!
Oh man! Oh, don't stop! Don't mount him! Get him! Get him! Yeah!
Oh!
That was amazing.
Okay. Let's do you and me one more time. Now that you've seen how the computer plays,
now that I've seen how the computer plays, maybe I can do this. Okay. What's the booster? Is A. Okay.
Y'all ready for this?
Yes. Alright, here we go.
Here we go.
Yeah,
oh
my
right.
God,
no!
That's right!
No.
Oh no! Oh yes!
Nice!
Yes!
Nice!
Okay, so the trick of this one is he uses his quick speed and the fact that he can get that bulldozer right underneath.
Yep.
And that's the tactic right there.
My strategy has to be this.
I gotta say, I'm impressed. That's a bit of a David and Goliath there.
Oh no!
Yeah.
You knocked it off already! Ah, crap! I don't have anything left!
I'll pick you apart piece by piece!
I'm gonna run away. No, you're not letting me run away.
Yeah, no, you're not gonna.
I got nothing left. Okay.
Didn't even need to push you off that time.
Dang it.
Oh, tiebreaker.
Oh boy.
Tiebreaker.
Okay,
this is for the title.
What did I do wrong?
This is for the TerraTech champion of the world.
Right, let's do this.
Of average giants. Because there are a lot of people that could kick the crap out of us. Will the same thing work?
Oh,
will it work?
No.
Oh.
Come on.
Get the wheel. Yeah. Okay. We're in good
I'm
shape.
Still moving.
Good shape.
I got my sideways thruster.
No. No, get away from him!
Yeah.
Get away from him!
Oh no, it fell off again!
Oh, yes! Oh.
I'm just gonna back away.
Okay, cool. What's up, bro?
Hey, look, I'm
hey, my laser, you dick!
Straight. Oh no!
Okay.
You won that one. At least I had some better
good
tactics
matches.
There. Yeah.
That was some good matches. Whoa, where am I going? Celebratory laugh!
Killing Stonehenge!
Get away out of, get out of my way, Stonehenge! You have no right to be here!
America! We should have called that America.
We have to now.
Because he just fucking screws shit.
Okay. Okay, so that was TerraTech's multiplayer version. Thank you so much for coming on the show, Russ.
Yes, it was fantastic.
Hey, no worries, guys. Great to see you having fun with it.
Congratulations on everything.
Yes, yeah. I wanted to have you guys back just on the simple fact that you got onto the Steam store. But with the Kickstarter as well, it's amazing news, and I cannot wait to see what you guys build with this game. Because even the alpha that we had when you first came on was amazingly fun, and this has just redoubled my thoughts of how fun this game is. So I can't see what you guys can do with another 6 months of programming.
It's going to be epic, man. Cool, yeah. Thanks very much.
Not a problem.
And now, our next game that we are going to be playing is a doozy.
Yeah,
I don't know if you've heard this one heard of this one before, but if you look up the Let's Player Markiplier, it drove him insane for a year. And it is called Vanish by Three Drunk Men. So we are going to be right back with a drink in hand and get ourselves scared.
Yep. Yeehaw! I love getting scared. Any of my fans know I hate horror games. Okay, guys, well, we'll be back in a few minutes, so make sure to stay tuned and join us for some Vanish gameplay.
Vanish! Ooh!